I'm Trail Tap. Normally I build trails. Today I'm gonna build a retro-themed 1990s trail bike. In the fall of 1992, at 14 years old, I sold all my worldly possessions and salvaged golf balls out of Chicago area golf ponds, scraping together the $1,400 needed to purchase my first full suspension mountain bike. I was 1,000 miles away from any mountain. The seed was sowed that Freedom Machine would one day take me there. That purchase would direct my future in every way. Where I lived, traveled, and dreamed were all driven by riding fat tires down skinny trails, ultimately leading me to my obsession with building modern, progressive bike trails. I remember seeing a Klein Adroit hanging on the wall of the local bike shop. The Gator Fade blue over green paint with blue anodized parts looked as fast as a fighter jet, invoking all the want. The $5,500 price tag is still a lot of money, 3 decades later. This brings us to my latest trail bike build, a tribute to the genius and progression Gary Klein left on the modern mountain bike. Gator Fade paint, rainbow and blue anodized everything, titanium bolts front to rear. This is my dream bike, 30 years in the making.
For this build, I went with my standard parts mix, full XTR drivetrain. Love the brakes, love the crispness of the shifting and the reliability of it. To me, there's nothing better. I always run Shimano. 130, 140 bike, so a detuned 36. This is all I need. The 38 I thought would be overkill, and it's a half pound lighter. We're going for a trail bike here. Don't need anything too robust. Kenda Pinner Pros. This is my go-to trusty tire. Envy, made in USA. Good warranty, no questions asked. And of course, the best part is this rubber rim strip. So you actually have protection against rock damage to keep your carbon rims fresh.
I always like my Onyx hubs. They're silent and they engage instantly.
Ergon GA3s for the grips. These reduce arm pump and actually just make you feel more comfortable on the bike. I can't ride anything else. Love my Ergons. And of course, better bolts. Every bolt on this bike is going to be titanium swapped, because after all, that's how we did it back in the day.
First order of business, get that sticky schmutz off your chain. It's worse than the back seat after prom night. Warm water, citrus degreaser, let's let that marinate. Proper bike needs a proper break-in. We're off to Dave Wood's $100,000 jump line. Let's hit it. We're finally here, the $100,000 jump line. We're above Palm Springs, California. Dave Woodworld built this. He's the best trail builder I know. My favorite jump line on my favorite bike. It's 1992 in my world. Today we are pairing White Castle sliders with a jump line session on the Trailfire grill. Check this out, 4-in-1. It's an oven, a wok, a barbecue, and a fire pit to keep you warm at night. And we're sliding. That's a wrap on my 1990s retro trail bike build. Thanks for following along. Support your local trail builder. And thank you to all the industry that you see here that supports me and trail builders like me. We appreciate the support. Good looking, lightweight, with a sweet paint job.
That's a big girl.
It's hard to build when you can't see that. I can't see out of these sunglasses. I just had the spacers. Oh my God, everything's a mess. The spacers were right here.